Hey everyone, how are you? I'm Dr. John Tann again with Metabolic and Bariatric Specialists. Just wanted to take a quick moment today to kind of go over a little bit of the basic anatomy. There's a lot of confusing pictures online when we're looking at bariatric surgery. What are we going to be around? Where are we going? What are we touching? What are we doing? And how is it different than it used to be? And how is it different than every other kind of surgery you have? Well, the first thing that I will show you is just kind of a little diagram here of what your inner abdominal area looks like. One of the things that we're gonna do is we're gonna go in there with small cameras, usually about the size of a pen, and we're gonna use those instruments to manipulate things inside. So right here, what you see first is the liver, and just like when we're doing surgery, we actually have to lift that liver out of the way so that we can see everything else. So here you can see your stomach, your esophagus is coming down. So when you swallow the food, this food comes down and goes inside your stomach. And then the stomach empties out into the duodenum, which is the first part of your small intestine. You can see that highlighted right here. The pancreas is the thing in yellow, and that has a lot of your digestive enzymes. And that has a lot of important things that we'll talk about in later episodes. The liver has a drainage system, and that's your gallbladder there. A lot of people know about people that have had their gallbladder out. And that liver drains into that small portion of the small bowel of the duodenum as well. Then after that, you have this next section of small bowel, which is gonna be the jejunum, and that's part number two. And it's actually quite long, and that plays a large part of digestion that we're gonna kind of be changing. And then the last part of your small bowel is gonna be the ileum. And again, that's gonna come up later. Now, your food and everything has to go through there, enzymes, digestion, and there's about 600 centimeters of small bowel, give or take. And that's gonna come in. I'm gonna talk about distances and things like that and as we describe the different types of surgeries. And then we have the colon, which is divided into three parts. So colon number one, colon number two, colon number three, and then that's where it leaves your body towards the end. So that's kind of the whole process of the different parts of the anatomy that we're gonna look at. And one last thing that I'm gonna kind of mention here is the division between your lungs and your and the abdomen. So your diaphragm is gonna sit up here like this, and that esophagus has gotta come through a hole. One of the things that we wanna make sure of is that that hole is not actually a big hole, and that perhaps part of your stomach has not moved up inside there, which is very common and can be called a hiatal hernia, which is very different than any other type of hernia. And sometimes we come upon that during surgery, or we'll find out about that before, and we'll fix that at the same time that we do your surgery. So just wanted to give you a quick overview of the overall anatomy as we get into further episodes where we talk about specific surgeries where we kind of play around with these different parts. Again, thanks for watching. We'll talk to you later.